All right, so remember, Charles, we were talking about three different kinds of ways of choosing the inputs to the learner. Okay, so what were they again? We just looked at two of them.
So the learner chooses examples. The teacher, hopefully a nice one, chooses examples. And then there was the case with the examples are given to us by nature. And I guess there was a fourth one, which is that a mean teacher gives it to us. But I don't think that's all that interesting. I tend to think of nature as a mean teacher.
Well, not only that, but at least in the mistake bound setting that we just looked at, again, the learner was robust against any choice of where the inputs were coming from. So a mean teacher, it would have done just as well, because
That's a fine point.
it doesn't matter when it makes its mistakes, it's only going to make a fixed number of them no matter what.
Okay.
So we kind of dealt with three of these, but we haven't really talked about the nature chooses case yet. And that's in some ways the most interesting and relevant, and in other ways the most complicated, because you have to really take into consideration this space of possible distributions. I think now, though, we're in a pretty good situation in terms of being able to define some important terms, and we're going to use those terms to get a handle on this question of what happens when nature chooses.
Okay, that seems reasonable.
So computational complexity, we talked about the how much computational effort is going to be needed for a learner to converge to the answer. Sample complexity, in the case of a batch, that is to say we have a training set, is how large does that training set need to be for the learner to be able to create successful hypotheses? And that's in the batch setting. In the online setting, we have this notion of a mistake bound. How many misclassifications can the learner make over an infinite run?
Can I ask you a question? You said something I thought pretty interesting. How much for computational complexity? You said how much computational effort is needed for a learner to converge to the right answer? Is that a requirement when you talk about computational complexity, or is it just that you need to know how much computational effort is needed for a learner to converge to something?
Well, so if it's converging to something, and we don't care what it's converging to, then it's really easy to have an algorithm with low computational complexity, right? It's just like return garbage. It runs in constant time. So yeah, it's in the context of actually solving the problem that computational complexity is most interesting.
Well, I was going to say, what if the set of hypotheses I'm willing to entertain doesn't include the true concept?
Ah, good. Right. So in some sense, maybe in that case, what we're trying to find is the best hypothesis in the hypothesis class. But we can still ask about computational complexity in that case. So I was saying successful hypothesis here. By that I meant, whatever it is that the problem demands that we return. And if it's a hypothesis class that's very limited, we might just return the best thing in that class.
Okay.
But the important thing here is that we're not going to talk about computational complexity for the most part. We're going to focus on sample complexity for the time being. And that's really the relevant concept when we're talking about the idea of nature choosing.
I believe you.